Balance of Nature, changing the world one life at a time.
You guys have a great product, and I tell my friends about it, and I was actually talking to a guy the other day who I just met, and he takes them. So you put out a great product, and I want to thank you and your organization.
I just started using it, and my family's already seen the difference. And I have health issues. I have fibromyalgia, asthma, but all of a sudden everything's clearing up, and I'm feeling better, and my skin's better. My brother said I look 10 years younger already.
Wow. Okay.
My vision is clear. I already see the difference. People are seeing the difference, and my doctor is seeing the difference.
Experience the Balance of Nature difference for yourself. For a limited time, you can receive a 30% discount and free shipping on your first preferred order of Balance of Nature. Call 800-246-8751 or go to balanceofnature.com and use discount code USA.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, just a skosh past the top of the hour, which means it is Thursday at long last. Thank goodness and welcome to it. I'm Charlie Jones. You're listening to the USA Radio Network. So glad to have your company. Phone number, 844-RADIO-US. That's 844-RADIO-US. My producer, Mr. Jet Williams, is ensconced in the highly secure and clandestine, it's the USA Master Control Room. He's got his thumb on the big red button and control of all the servers and all the gee-whiz blinking lights. He will be happy to take your phone call should you decide to contact the program and enrich us with your particular perceptions on the affairs of the day. That phone number, 844-723-4687, 844-723-4687. Now, if I may, let me get completely candid with you. Full disclosure, I thought that today was going to be the single most boring congressional hearing ever. There's only been two congressional hearings that went anywhere. One was when 1974, when the Senate Watergate Committee found out about the White House taping system and therefore the existence of the White House Nixon tapes. That changed everything. It was an absolute thunderclap. It reverberated for weeks in the news-making parts of the nation. Same story with the Clinton impeachment when the proverbial Monica Lewinsky blue dress was discovered. It was just an absolute shockwave, a sonic boom in the newsmaking department. But since then, that would be 1998, there hasn't been anything anywhere near that interesting. And technically, there wasn't anything like that today. In order to make this work, what the Democrats had to do was put together a completely convincing reality TV show that would basically be a television version of the Mueller report. That's what they thought they were going to do. And they thought somehow they could get Robert Mueller to do that for them. But At first I wasn't watching, I was just hearing blurbs people were picking up and passing on. But as I heard Mueller begin to reveal his remarkable lack of familiarity with his own report, I was floored. He apparently didn't write much of it, either that or he doesn't remember it, poor guy. It is as though he completely lost interest. And I mean, I'll tell you, his congressional performance in testimony, technically now yesterday, I think completely extinguished any flickering hope that the Democrats might have had or might have had for removing the president from office for his term is over with, for the next election. It's just not going to happen. I mean, there was probably a moment, however brief, at the beginning of all this foolishness yesterday in the House Judiciary Committee, where there was at least some slight small possibility of altering the growing resolution against impeachment. And I'll tell you where, when I began to get the realization that wasn't going to happen. It was in the course of the questioning by a California Democrat, a real liberal weasel named Ted Lieu. And he said this to Mueller. He said, quote, "I'd like to ask you the reason again that you did not indict Donald Trump because of OLC, Office of Legal Counsel opinion, stating that you cannot indict a sitting president, correct? And when Mueller said that is correct, I thought, oh, here comes the smut Martha. He's just, and I thought, wait just a minute. When he and Attorney General Bill Barr had their little confab at the production of the report, the unveiling of the report, Bill Barr said he asked him three separate times, did you not indict because of the Office of Legal Counsel opinion? And he said no. He said no three times. So when he said that's correct to Ted Lieu, I thought, boy, howdy, it really got my attention. And that was about 9 o'clock Texas time, give or take, yesterday. So if you took that, along with his later testimony that the president could be charged after he left office, the implication was clear that the only thing saving Donald Trump from criminal charges by the Democrats would be the presidency. But then, early in the afternoon, Mueller walked it back. He told the House Intel Committee, I want to go back to one thing that was said this morning by Ted Lieu, who said, and I quote, you didn't charge the president, blah, blah, blah. He said, that is not the correct way to say it. As we say in the report, and as I said at the opening, we did not reach a determination as to whether the president committed a crime. Now, you either indict or you don't. And if you don't indict, that means your determination is there's no crime there. If you indict, you expect to be able to convict. But if you don't indict, that means you don't think you can convict, so you don't have evidence of a crime. But, I mean, just think about that. Just like that. As soon as early in the afternoon, Mueller went back and corrected his testimony, just like that, all the Democrat public hallucination fantasizing about impeachment dried up and blew away like gasoline on hot concrete on a summer day. Just whoosh, gone. And that's the thing about this hearing. Just like Monica's blue dress or just like the Nixon Watergate tapes, going into this hearing, what all these big fans of impeachment really needed was either some explosive new allegations or some kind of, or the very kind of prosecutorial performance that Bob Mueller, bless his heart, just wasn't able to produce. Some kind of a compelling prosecutorial performance to make it look as though he's in control and Trump's in trouble. And it would basically artificially resuscitate the interest in impeachment, but it just didn't happen. Now, if they could have gotten both things, a convincing TV show and a compelling performance from Bob Mueller, then the local demand to launch a formal impeachment inquiry would have been massive by the end of the deal. But neither one of those things happened. If you watch this thing all day long, and you've got more patience than I do, if you did, there were no explosive new facts, none. And Mueller, frankly, did not give anything but a compelling prosecutorial performance. The nicest way to talk about how Mueller did today, here was a guy that didn't want to testify. He clearly didn't want to be there. He objected to the proceedings and had made the statement several times that his written work should stand for itself, although I'm not sure it's his written work anymore. He either has no interest in the work itself and therefore didn't retain much of it, or he didn't do much of it. But it wasn't a Clarence Darrow moment. It wasn't a Perry Mason moment. It wasn't an Atticus Finch moment. There were simply no prosecutorial finesses here. In fact, there weren't any finesses at all. Of all the things I expected to happen, this was not one of them. Let me get a slug of coffee here. Hold on a sec. Oh, yeah, that's good stuff. Okay, now, the thing that I was fascinated by, what the Democrats needed to do was highlight the most damaging parts of the Mueller report and get Mueller to read them and talk about them, because they figured that the TLDR public, you know, too long didn't read, that the public likely hadn't even read a page. And I think they were frustrated by that, and they thought they could fix it by having Mueller read it for them. But in this particular respect, I think Mueller was well briefed. He didn't give the Democrats anything they wanted, not a thing. I mean, consider he didn't give them any quote, any 20 seconds of stuff they could use for a campaign commercial or that they could hand off to a Huffington Post or whoever. He didn't give them any of that. And it was partly because his performance was so spotty and so just plain pitiful. There was nothing they could use there. It's like, in Don Henley's Dirty Laundry, give me something I can use. Because that's what the Democrats were looking for, and that is not what they got. And if you think about this, what was the reason for the hearing to start with? What was the hearing for the reason? The reason for the hearing, there we go. Was it not to explore the underlying evidence that the report was based on. That's what we were told. We're going to explore the underlying report, the things that people, the American people, don't know, and they need to hear all the terrible things that are in this report. And when they hear these terrible things, why, they'll be four square in favor of impeachment. But as the morning turned into the afternoon, and this session dragged on, just, oh God, did you notice? You notice all the questions about the underlying evidence that concerning the report? Well, if you didn't, you're doing fine, and you really watched, because there was not one question about the underlying evidence the report was based on asked by any Democrat anywhere. And there were a lot of very heads-up questions asked by the Republicans, and it was fascinating to watch Mueller walk away from them. And, you know, after a while, they'd ask him a question, he'd ask him to repeat it, and one guy asked him a question, and he asked and repeated. It was a short question. It was a 14-word question. And Mueller couldn't hold the front end against the back end for 14 words. The guy had to repeat it. And in a sense, and this is a terrible thing to say, but in a sense, it was like watching, it was senior abuse. It was as though the Democrats knew good and well that Mueller was having trouble remembering things, and they were reading things fast. They were peppering him with difficult concepts and expecting immediate answers and tapping their foot, you know, both figuratively and literally. And it was like, and especially with Gerald Nadler. Gerald Nadler made Mueller his little dancing monkey. He really did. Made him like Gerald Nadler was the organ grinder, and Mueller was the organ grinder's monkey. It was a sad thing. And I will give Mueller this. In not giving the Democrats anything that they could use later on, he was at least well-prepped enough in that particular respect. And after a while, I kind of thought, well, maybe. Is it possible that he's doing this on purpose? That he's faking it? That he's doing this so they'll leave him alone? That he doesn't want any part of this and thinks it's a national circus and could care less about it? I don't know. But watching this, and I was later joined by my lovely and talented wife, who got home from work early, and we were sitting there ensconced on the couch and talking over the issues of the day. And I said, "Have you seen this?" And I flicked it on, and she'd been in the car; she'd heard a bunch of it on the radio, but hadn't seen anything. And she turns and looks at me and says, "Jones, you know what this reminds me of? Do you remember that scene in The Wizard of Oz when Toto pulls the curtain back and there's the wizard working all the controls that make the image of the wizard appear? And he says, 'Pay no attention to that little man behind the curtain.'" It was as though today we watched the curtain pulled aside from the whole Russia collusion witch hunt hoax and saw how little there really is behind this. This big, bad former director of the FBI, Eagle Scout, total prosecutor, all this other stuff, all these things he was supposed to be were graphically stripped away. And he was, in no small sense, pitiful. And it must have been tremendously embarrassing for him. And if this is typical, of course, now think about, remember the 8-minute, it was about 8.5-minute press conference he did, didn't take any questions, went out and read a statement. And his voice kind of shook while he read it, and then stalked off the stage, and that was that. What we saw all day now yesterday was very much that same person. And I hate to say it, but man, for him to be that way then, and then here we are weeks later, he's still that way now. Something's happened. And the Democrats must have known this. There's no way they couldn't be aware of this. They must have had some kind of contact with him before this took place. But they did it anyway. I think senior abuse is an effective moniker here. Be right back. Stay close. All you got is this
moment. I used to wonder when I saw people going into nice hotels, really nice hotels, taking a pillow with them. That was before I got a MyPillow, because I know it doesn't matter where I'm going. Whether I'm going to a 1-star, 3-star, 5-star hotel, MyPillow goes with me, whether it's just overnight or whether it's on vacation. And here's the great deal about MyPillow right now. The lowest price ever offered on radio or TV. 2 MyPillow premium pillows for $69.98. That's only $34.99 per pillow. The lowest price ever offered on radio or TV. And it's still the same pillow. Great pillow. 60-day money-back guarantee. 10-year warranty. And call them. 1-800-951-8175 or Go to MyPillow.com, use promo code USA, click on the two-pack special, and get the best deal you've ever gotten on a good night's sleep when you get a MyPillow.
Hi, I'm Wade Allyn-Root for Amp Fest 19. Amp Fest 19 is the most entertaining political event and Trump Fest of the year. For any conservative who wants to be empowered and entertained, or for any Trump superfan who wants to just have a blast, if that's you, head to the Trump Doral Hotel on October 10th to 12th in sizzling, sexy Miami, Florida. Headliner speakers at Amp Fest 19 include Sarah Huckabee Sanders, Dinesh D'Souza, Charlie Kirk of the Turning Point USA, Brandon Straka of the Walkaway Movement, and of course, yours truly, Wade Allyn-Root. I love that guy. But this is more than a traditional political event or Trump Love Fest. Amp Fest 19 features a Texas Hold'em poker tournament, golf tournament, comedy night, pool party, yacht party, fashion show, movie screening, Women for Trump social, and prayer breakfast hosted by Alveda King. To register for Amp Fest 19, just go to AmericanPriority.com. That's AmericanPriority.com. It all happens October 10th to 12th at the Trump Doral in sizzling, sexy Miami. I'll see you there. AmericanPriority.com.
Got an old car? You can donate it, whether it's running or not, to the United Breast Cancer Foundation and save a life. They'll even come and pick it up for free. The United Breast Cancer Foundation has saved hundreds of women's lives through their free or low-cost breast screen exams. But now they need your help. The United Breast Cancer Foundation wants to save more lives through early detection by offering women free or low-cost breast screening exams. And donating your old car, SUV, or truck, whether it's running or not, helps pay for them. Plus, you get a charitable tax deduction. Help the United Breast Cancer Foundation save lives by donating your old car, SUV, or truck. Call now for free pickup. 800-280-2144. 800-280-2144. 800-280-2144. Call right now. That number again is 800-280-2144. Does your business spend $500 a month or more on gas and electric bills? Did you know by making a simple free phone call, you can save up to 25% on your bill every month? What could you do with a 25% savings on utility bills every month? Energy deregulation is now available in your state. Making one simple phone call will show you how we can lower your gas and electric bills instantly, with no changes to your bill and no enrollment fee. This is a free service. The only thing you'll notice is a lower bill every month. Call U.S. Power and Light right now. Learn how easy it is to lower your utility bills for your business and save money. We promise. So if you spend over $500 a month on your gas and electric bills, please call right now and unleash your savings.
800-941-3381. 800-941-3381. 800-941-3381. That's 800-941-3381.
Have you written a book and want to get it published? Then call Page Publishing at 800-605-6995. Immediately. That's 800-605-6995. Page Publishing is looking for authors of all types of books. And unlike most publishers, Page Publishing will take the time to review each and every book submitted to them and give you their feedback. If they like what they read, they'll get your book into bookstores and for sale online at Amazon, the Apple iTunes Store, Barnes & Noble, and other outlets. They handle everything: editing, cover design, copyright protection, printing, publicity, and distribution. So if you've written a novel, children's book, cookbook, inspirational work, poetry, or a biography and want to get it published, then you need to call Page Publishing and do it immediately. Call 800-605-6995 now for your free author submission kit. Again, for your free author submission kit, call 800-605-6995. That's 800-605-6995. Your road to fame and fortune could very well start with this simple phone call. Call Page Publishing at 800-605-6995 for your free author submission kit.
They thought this is going to be the lightning storm. Four minutes after the hour, Jones here on the USA Radio Network. In some respects, watching the Democrats today, watching the Democrat dreams of impeachment fizzle out and just blow away in the wind, it reminds me of a scene in Young Frankenstein when Gene Wilder is beating on the still dead corpse of the monster, going, "How could you do this to me? How could you do this to me?" This is the Democrats. They were so sure that the Mueller report was going to be the Frankenstein monster that would destroy Trump. It would destroy OMB, Orange Man Bad. But it didn't happen because going into the hearing, they needed the lightning of explosive new claims and some kind of a compelling performance from Mueller to generate a new interest and a new image to basically reanimate the monster, the Mueller report, and get it up off the table and walk around. But they got a fizzle here. No new explosive facts, no bombshells, and Mueller was anything but compelling. And so all these things they were hoping. And see, the thing about it is, the Democrats, when what they understood was that the public likely hadn't read a page, not a single page of the report. And the reason is, by the time the report was delivered, most of us had already absorbed and evaluated all the damaging stuff that Rachel Maddow and the rest of those folks could throw at President Trump, all the nasty things they can say about his conduct, all the nasty conspiracy theories, all the nasty, just it's vicious carrier, pure and simple. And they'd been doing every new charge, every new claim, every new revelation would only move the needle just a tiny little bit. And so by the time that the report got here, I think most Americans had made up their minds. And try to imagine the Democrats' frustration when they were constantly interrupted and frustrated by Republicans all day long who used their time wisely and had the right questions thought up to attack the credibility of the investigation itself and, by virtue of asking the tough questions to Mueller, pull the curtain away and show the wizard as he truly was and not how he was built up to be. So there you have some of that. And the thing about it is, in order to make impeachment work, you have to collectively change the minds of the American public. Impeachment requires changing of minds. On the Democrat side, you have to change the Democrat minds about the risks of impeachment. Is it politically wise to attempt to remove a sitting president because it may hurt you in the next election? Witness what didn't happen to Bill Clinton. And they also need to change Republican minds that maybe they've been defending the wrong guy. But the Republicans are solidly behind Trump, like 89%. That's huge. And to get the ball rolling, impeachment requires a bombshell. In Watergate, it was the Watergate tapes. For Bill Clinton's impeachment, it was the blue dress. Those were the bombshells that got the ball rolling for impeachment back in those times. Those were the only two successful times that all these hearings have been held in all these years ever produced. Every impeachment requires a certain moment, a certain aha moment. Nixon tapes, Lewinsky dress. Instead, what we got, the Mueller report. What is the Mueller report? It's a legal brief, crashingly boring. Nobody reads these things. I mean, there are people that are serious insomniacs that read some of this and fall asleep. I mean, that's how bad it is. And the thing is, there is no wave of public support. There wasn't one yesterday. It didn't generate and come ashore today during the hearings. And this hearing was what I expected was a choreographed, rehearsed, produced TV show. And we didn't get one. It was a dud. And when you think about this, who could have helped him? Like I said previously, that would be Donald Trump. 12 years of experience crafting a number one award-winning reality show called The Apprentice. He knew how to produce this. They didn't. And trust me on this, the mainstream media is quite well aware that it was a dud. When we come back, George Stephanopoulos, F. Chuck Todd, Terry Moran for ABC News. You will not believe the almost universal holding of the nose that the media is doing regarding the stink of the dud that landed on the congressional stage yesterday. Jones here on the USA Radio Network, back in just a minute. Stay close.
Do you wish you could get better sleep and maybe lose a few pounds? Maybe more than a few pounds? Well, there's this product called Calitrin that helps with both sleep and weight loss. Just listen to what people are saying about it.
I've been taking Calitrin for right about 3 months, and I've lost 24 pounds and 19 overall inches. But my sleep has improved, I have so much more energy, and I have the desire to succeed more than ever. Anyone who needs weight loss, more energy, and better sleep, this product really does deliver.
I'm Roger. Over the 3 months that I took the product, My sleeping habits are increasingly much better. I got a better night's sleep, and I just can't say enough about the product and how it makes you feel. Also, additionally lost a little bit of weight on the program as well.
Hi, this is Aronson. I take Calitrin for weight loss, and I've lost about 20 pounds, and I feel great.
Calitrin is scientifically proven to help with sleep and weight loss safely and effectively. Check it out at toploss.com. That's toploss.com.